So this is a video on the topic of what to pack when preparing to compete in a national physique committee show, or what to take when you're going on a road trip. So you could be competing locally, or you could be traveling to compete in another state. My name is Mindy Irish, and I am an amateur bikini competitor with the National Physique Committee. I compete in the Masters and Open division, and I'm now in my sixth season of competing. I am an online coach for Women's General Fitness and for competitors, and I also do posing coaching. So I wanted to take this time as I'm packing for the Arnold here in almost early March 2018, and maybe give you some tips so that you could get some ideas on what to pack for your next show. My very first season of competing, I coached myself, and I used Pauline Norden's Fighter Diet contest prep regimen. And within that, she gave a great layout. So if you're coaching yourself or you're just getting started, I highly recommend purchasing that ebook. It was maybe $25, $30 at the time. And it gave a lot of tips that helped someone really know what to expect. Within that ebook, she provided a great list of items to bring to a show, and I have used that every time I've packed. So I'm gonna be following that, and I wanted to give her due credit, but I'm also going to show you a few other things that I like to bring that have benefited me, and I'll explain why. I like to bring two pieces of exercise bands, so I tie these together. I don't always pump up backstage, but in the case that we don't have access to the hotel gym, or it is you're just wanting to do a light circuit, then it's nice to have these. I will say that at one show, my bands walked, so don't take anything that's of high value. Take something that you can easily replace. I take, for the road trip, we've got a 3-hour drive, so I take a couple items that I want to read. You might have some downtime backstage, and I find it really nice, in my experience, to put the phone down and step away from social media and the buzz and just decompress so that I can stay in the moment and I do better on stage that way. So having some non-electronic items to read have been beneficial to me. I do travel with my scale, so I've got my scale here. I like to weigh myself each morning. It helps me gauge how I'm holding water, how my body's responding to my plan. Each show, I self-coach now. I was formerly coached by 3 professional bodybuilders over the course of about 4.5 years. So I'm currently self-coaching, and each show is basically a document of myself that I use to build on for upcoming shows. So it's basically just creating that data that you want to gather, whether you're being coached or you're coaching yourself. All of that is data on how you respond to the stimulus and the circumstances, and that's why I travel with the scale, just to know how I come in for show day. I like to travel with This is a simple little carry-on that you might travel with if you're on an airplane. A couple times I've flown to a show, but this is basically what I will take backstage. And I like it because it has a handle. So you'll want to do something that is easy to pull and take your items backstage. You won't want a ton backstage because you just want less to manage. But I always pull this behind so that when I'm hair and makeup and suit and tan on, I'm not carrying anything. And that's really important. You don't want anything on your body. So I travel with this, and then when I go backstage, this is what I use to take my necessities with me. Of course, I've got my heels, and this is my second pair of heels in my 6 years, so I'm getting close to the end of this pair. I use the Ellie brand, and I use the clear and no straps. That's just the way I started. A lot of gals are using straps, but For me, I prefer to kick my shoes off when I'm backstage and give my feet a break, and I don't want to have to necessarily bend over and attach those each time. So I prefer the ones that are just the traditional open back. And I buy these locally at a lingerie store. And I know you can also purchase them online. I travel with my sleep mask because I want to get really quality sleep at night. So I sleep with that every night, which helps me get a deep sleep and then take it when I'm traveling. This may sound silly, but take tampons. Women, you can understand this. I started my period at the Masters Nationals the day before the show. Didn't even know it was coming. My system was running really well, and that was a big surprise. I have also had my period the day of the show, and it happened. So be prepared to have these in your bag, as you just never know what your body will do in this time of a crazy situation with being low body fat and higher stress. I use Halo Couture extensions. So the morning, tomorrow is my day before show. I compete on Thursday, so Wednesday morning, I get up and wash my hair, dry it, no makeup, shave my entire body, and then Wednesday evening, I'll be tanning with Liquid Sunrays. And then Thursday morning, I will be up with my halos on and getting my hair and makeup done. So don't forget your hair, and a lot of us use hair extensions. And then I've got my suit and a backup suit. Most shows will be checking your suit cut if you're in a bikini. So it's always wise to have a backup suit in case you have a suit malfunction. That hasn't happened to me yet, but it's just better safe than sorry. And if you don't have one in your beginning seasons, don't worry about it. But as you start to progress into competing, you'll collect suits, and you'll just want to keep one as a backup. One tip that I learned, thanks to Pauline early on, was Vaseline. I use Vaseline right before I go on stage, and I'll put it on the inside of my lips. You're going to be dry, you're going to be nervous, you're going to be a little anxious, and it helps to have a little bit of moisture on the inside of your lips because when you're on stage, it helps you smile. And it keeps that it keeps you from being too dry and your lips from sticking to your teeth. So I put a little bit of this on before I go out, and it's helped me every time. Don't forget your stage jewelry. Everyone's is going to be different, but I just keep mine in a linen closet, so when I'm ready to compete, it's all right in here, and I just grab it and go. So what I like to go tanning in is you always want to tan in something very, after tanning, something very loose, and for me, dark. These are like a very loose yoga pant, easy to get on and off. And then this is actually like a pseudo top dress, and it's just easy to slip on and off of me when my hair is done. And I'll tan and then put it right back up. And then you sleep in these so that the tan does not get on the sheets, nor does the sheets rub it off of your body. And then the next day when I go get hair and makeup done, I go in this. When I'm ready to be walking around backstage, I do wear a cuter little over cover up. It's more like a swimsuit cover up. It's also easy to get on and off, so when I'm closer to the stage and less chance of being hit with anything, maybe from my kids or from any transition in the hotel room at night, then I can be a little more exposed. The coverage here helps to protect my tan. So this is what I'll wear when I'm backstage. And then always remember your flip-flops. You wear these in to tan, wear them out of tanning, just easy on and off stage routine. Like I said, if I'm going to take my heels off, then I have some alternate shoes. You don't want to walk around down into to the venue in your heels, save those right when you're about ready to go on stage. Something I've learned along the way in my years of competing is that you want to collect old sheets and old towels. So when you're traveling, not all the hotels will provide this, but some of the hotels who have been used to hosting bodybuilding shows will have them provided for you. And so what you can do is utilize old sheets and towels and take them with you from show to show. When you get out of the shower after you're done competing, you're going to be shedding that tan, and you will get charged. I've been charged by the hotel if you get it on their nice, white, clean linens. So take your old linens, sheets, put it on the bed at night, pull their pretty stuff off, put the sheets on, and protect yourself and save some money. And then just package these up and bring them home with you. If you're in town competing locally, do the same thing. I just get my bed prepared at night, sleep in my black clothes, get up in the morning and go. And then I have towels, I have a bath mat, and I also have just another black backup towel. You can get it at Walmart, anywhere, Target. Just always great to have that on hand, and you'll use it show after show. And then the last thing I want to show you, in addition to your toiletries, in addition to your curling irons, you know, clothes going into the show, training gear, however long you're in town or traveling, it's kind of easy to travel and when you're competing because you don't need a lot. You're in your suit all day, you're tanned, you're in some cover-ups, and you're low-key. So maybe after the show you're fight-seeing and you want some different clothes, but in the times I have traveled, it's lighter, actually. One other tip I have, and I've got a lot of nutrition info out on my YouTube channel, preparing for road trips, preparing for shows. But one other tip I have is I save plastic water bottles, and I drink about 7 ounces at a time when I'm competing backstage day of show. So we will load these plastic water bottles up with about 7 to 8 ounces, so I don't have to be measuring backstage. And then if I want to grab them out of my bag in between classes or as I'm getting ready to go on stage, I can just have a little swig and I know that I'm not oversaturating. So those are some quick tips that I have for you. I just repeat that show and show again, and it works for me. If you have any questions, let me know. My website is mindyirish.com, and you can email me with questions for posing or coaching at mindy@mindyirish.com. Have a great day, and I wish you well in your competition season.